Kula here. Hope you guys are having a great day. I was having a pretty good day, and then I got home and then things kind of started to go downhill, oddly enough. Like, for some reason, our apartment was out of hot water, so I had to take a cold shower, and I didn't realize it, so I got in the shower and things like that. But things are going okay now. I think things have settled down. For this video, I have a haul for you guys. I kind of want to get into this pretty quick here because this is a pretty big haul. This is kind of a collection since the end of January. I've been waiting to do this haul until I got an order from Ulta in, and it took forever to get here. I ordered it the end of January. It didn't ship till like 3 or 4 business days after I ordered it, and it got to my city on the 4th of February, and I didn't get it until the 10th. So it took forever, but I really want to make this video, like I said. I also really kind of am on a time crunch to make it because there's some stuff in the Ulta order I'm going to exchange. I'll kind of show you why. But like I said, it's going to be a haul. It's pretty big. It's a collection, kind of a bunch of stuff I've purchased since the end of January. Like I said, I'm on a time crunch too, so I didn't really feel too much like making this video, so I kind of just slapped on some BB cream and some mascara and called it good. So if there's anything going on, I apologize, but we're going to get right into this. I'm going to start probably with my online orders. I know I've showed you kind of one thing before. So kind of my longest ago purchase, I guess, was from Sephora. I ended up ordering the Skin Bender Volume 1 kit from online. If you guys have seen my other videos, you know I got the Volume 2 kit in store. I bought this online just not for any real reason. It just was easier. I mean, it's been like so cold here, that's kind of why I did a couple online orders, just because I haven't been able to leave my house basically, so that's kind of why I picked this up online. I got the 3 samples with it. I got a sample of the Glam Glow eye mask. I'm, you know, super into masks, and I'm interested in eye masks especially. I think they're kind of more rare than regular masks, and I've heard this is pretty good, so I'm gonna try this out. I got a sample of this BB cream for just no reason then besides the fact that it wasn't a fragrance. And then I picked up this sample of the Elizabeth and James Black and White Nirvanas. This is both of them. This is Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen's new fragrance. I believe this is a Sephora exclusive. Unfortunately, neither of my spray pumps work, so like I can't try it. But they actually smell really nice, and that kind of makes me sad. So I'm thinking next time I actually like go to a Sephora, I might just ask for samples. Because I really like how the Nirvana Black smells. It's kind of like dark and husky, but not overly like husky. I don't know, it's hard to explain, but I'm kind of sad I can't try these out, but I was glad I could smell them. I also got a VIB gift. I got this NARS Orgasm Illuminator. They said this was a deluxe sample size, and if you look on the website, this bottle does look different, but this is 1.1 ounces. And that's how big they say the full size is. So I don't know if this is actually a full size or what, but this was a VIB Rouge only kind of thing. This is the color, just like a liquid illuminator in, you know, the Orgasm color from NARS. It's like a peachy pink with gold shimmer. Super pretty. You do not need a lot of this. This will definitely last me a really long time. Like, this is way too much, like even for your face. But it just kind of blends out in the sheer kind of illuminating color. Oh, the only problem is that it's really, really glittery. So if you don't want to be glittery, that's not really something I'd recommend. And then Sephora, once again, is continuing to push their fragrances. They include this Sense of Desire postcard kit. So this is actually kind of cool. Like, these postcards, and they'll show, that is sideways, that's upside down. There we go. So they'll show, like, the perfume, and then the back, you can try it, and you can write stuff and mail it, but I'm not sure why you would mail someone these. But I thought that was really cool, really interesting marketing technique. So that is my Sephora order. So I suppose next I'll talk about the Ulta order, which took forever to get here. If I can get it out from under my desk. Okay, so this is my box here. It came in a surprisingly small box. I think I'm just really used to Sephora's boxes being like way too big for what you buy. And this was really compact and it fit everything really snugly. I ended up buying a lot from Ulta. This was when I had my 20% off coupon. I didn't really want to go to Ulta just because it was so cold outside. I need to pick up some more of my hair things because Ulta is the only place that carries a specific conditioner I like to use. So that's what I got. And I got a whole bunch of other stuff. I kind of arbitrarily assumed I had to spend $50 to get free shipping at Ulta. But looking on the website, I think you only have to spend $25. which is great because since they do sell drugstore products, like it's a little bit more difficult to buy $50 worth of drugstore products just to get free shipping than it is to say like on Sephora to buy high-end makeup and get free shipping after $50. So with my 20% off, I ended up spending like $50.40 because I thought like I had to get to $50 for free shipping. So I got a lot of things. I'm pretty excited about most of them though. So kind of the two things that I had to get for sure was my balancing rinse essential daily conditioner from WeDod, and for some reason like these are sealed, they come sealed, but they like scotch tape them closed, which was weird. And then I picked up another Moisture Lock leave-in conditioner. I really like this leave-in conditioner. My only problem with it is that it has a baby powder smell, and I really don't like baby powder smells. And unfortunately this is one of the products I'm gonna have to go exchange. Somehow it gooped everywhere, even though it's still sealed. Like, I couldn't find the break in the seal, but there's like goo everywhere and it's kind of gross, so I'm just gonna exchange that. And then I picked up, this Queen Helene Mint Julep Mask. I've heard a lot about this face mask. I'm super into face masks. This is for helping, you know, dry up acne and rinse away blackheads, shrink enlarged pores, problems I have. Unfortunately, you know, this does have fragrance and parabens in it, but everything else sounds pretty okay. Like, it's kind of pretty standard facial mask stuff. It smells really minty. Like, it smells like peppermint gum. So, I'm gonna try that out. I've just heard a lot of good things about that product. I've never, like, seen it in a store. I don't know if I've never just not looked for it before, but excited to try that. I also picked up a couple masks, if I can find the other one. Oh, there it is, okay. So I picked up two Body Shop masks. This is the Tea Tree Mask. This is good for acne. And then I picked up the Seaweed Ionic Clay Mask here. I also picked up this eyebrow pencil from Prestige. It apparently is this like ridiculously cheap brand. But this had a lot of really good reviews, so I figured I'd give it a try. I don't know if you guys ever noticed, but I don't do anything with my eyebrows besides like minimal maintenance, and even then sometimes I'm lazy because I'm blonde, so you can't really tell. But I thought maybe it might be a good time to start trying and seeing like how I can improve on that, just because eyebrows do really frame your face, and a subtle change in your eyebrows can really open up your eyes, open up your face, just make you look more groomed, and things like that. So I picked this up in blonde. This was on sale. I haven't opened this yet, but I think this color should be okay. This was the lightest color they had, and I have pretty light eyebrows, so we'll see how that goes. There's a little brush on the end here too. I picked up two Maybelline products because they had a buy one, get one 50% off. I picked up a Rocket Mascara because I've just heard a lot of good things about this mascara as well, and I really liked the Cat Eye Mascara, so I'm interested in trying more of the Maybelline mascaras. I got this in the non-waterproof formula because I don't really like waterproof mascara. It's just so hard to get off, and if I ever do need it to be waterproof, I do have that Anastasia Beverly Hills waterproofing clear coat thing. I got very black. There was a couple of other blacks you could get. There was like, I don't remember, I don't think very black was the blackest one you could get. This is another product though I'm gonna exchange. This is just me being weird, but like on the back, I don't know if you guys can see it, but there's all these kind of gross brown smudges. I don't know what they are. I don't know where they're from. I don't like them. Because nothing in my, you know, order was that color, it would smudge like that. So I don't know. So I'm gonna exchange this as well. And then I picked up another one of the Maybelline Master Glazes cheek sticks. I love my coral, my sheer coral one. This is just pinched pink. So I'm gonna give this one a try, but I'm just super into these kind of like cream, you know, not powder blushes, just because I love the transparency and the fact you can build them up. And then for my three samples, I picked the variety pack, and I actually really like Ulta's variety pack samples because you really do get a variety and it's kind of neat. So I got this Freshwater Mist Ulta Body Lotion. I got this set from TGI Catwalk for curls. And I got this cute little sample of Gardner's Hand Helper Cream. So that's cool. So that's my Ulta order. That, like I said, took forever to get here. Like, I ordered it at the end of January and it just got here. So I don't know what its problem was. I also actually went to the physical Ulta store because it warmed up and they were having a special on Zoya nail polish. So if you bought two Zoya polishes, you got this cute little set. So I got Addison and I got Giovanna, I think is how you say this one. I believe this one was from fall. So I got these two. Not really attached to these two, really. Like, I didn't go there specifically with these in mind. I know that Zoya just released their Naturals collection. I have a lot of natural nail polish, so I wasn't really interested in that, and my Ulta was really picked over. But these are those two swatches here. This is Addison, and this is Giovanna. And then the little kit you got is this cute little gift here. It says it's worth $20 and is exclusively for Ulta. And then inside, you get four things. And it comes in this cute Zoya tissue paper here. So you get a little bottle of Remove Plus, you get an Anchor base coat, you get a matte top coat, which is nice. I like matte top coats. I think they're fun. I have one from Julep, so it'll be nice to try the matte top coat from a different brand. And then they have one of their Hot Lips glossy lip balms. This is in the color Flirt. It's kind of a natural nudie brown color, kind of goes with the nude theme. So I thought that was really cool and well worth my trek there. And I also got to use my $3.50 off coupon. So like these two polishes and this kit cost me like $14, which is pretty neat. Let's see, we'll move on to more physical stores. My husband and I went shopping in our big mall. I guess if you haven't figured it out by now, when I say our big mall, I mean the Mall of America, which is a big mall. We live close enough where it's really easy for us to get there, and there was a time in our lives we were there like every single week because we lived like literally like a 5-minute drive away, so it was really cool. So I picked up some things from there. One thing my husband and I really like, we really like crane games and like carnival games, and inside the Mall of America there is the Nickelodeon Universe, which is that big amusement park, and they do have carnival games. My husband and I played the one with the ping pongs and you throw them in the little cups in the water, and I ended up winning twice. I think this one is significantly cuter, and then the second time I won I got this, and this is like such horrible quality. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it, but that was exciting. It's always exciting to win. And then I went to Urban Outfitters and I got a couple things there. Sorry, I keep looking down because it's where everything is. I never really buy anything full price from Urban Outfitters because obviously like they're really overpriced, but they do have some cute weird stuff there, and if you can get it on sale you can get a really good deal on some really nice stuff. So I got these mouse shoes. So they're little mice and they're really soft and fuzzy on the inside, and these are only $5, which is great. My only problem is one of these buckles is sewed on backwards, which might be why it was so cheap, but these are just super cute and I'm just going to use them as house shoes, so I was really excited to get those. And then my husband really wanted this cup. We got a glow-in-the-dark Illuminati pint glass, and this was like $3. So I was really excited about that. And then in the mall when we went, Caribou Coffee was doing the special promotion for their Pinterest board. They have this gigantic Pinterest board, it's like 60 feet tall. And they're giving away free samples of their new coffee blend, which I believe is called Real Inspiration Blend Coffee. And then they're giving out these free notebooks. So there's these really cute like felt covered notebooks, and there's some pages in here that are lined, and then there's some pages in here that are dotted, and it's just, it was a cool free notebook, and I got some free coffee, and it's pretty neat. And the coffee is really good, like, it just, I got a little cup of it, and I didn't really put any milk or sugar in it, because I didn't want to go near that table, because that's where they're taking pictures of the Pinterest board, and I didn't really want to be on the Pinterest board, but I don't usually like straight coffee, but it was good, so that was exciting, and this notebook's really cool. And then we went to, well, I guess I went to the MAC store because they have their Fantasy of Flowers. I think the collection's called Fantasy of Flowers. And there were two things from there that I really wanted to pick up. I got two of the mineral eyeshadow quads from that collection. I got Pink Sensibilities and Golden Hours. I'm not going to swatch these for you guys because otherwise this video would be way too long, and there's a lot of really good videos already out there of these being swatched. These are the mineral shadows, and the reason why I really wanted to get these was because they are like quads, but they're still like the regular price of a regular mineral eyeshadow. So for $21, I got four MAC mineral eyeshadows. They are kind of sheer, that's kind of the point of them. You can make them more intense by using like Fix Plus or using water, which won't damage them because they are minerals, and I really like them. I think I like Pink Sensibilities more. I initially just was going to get Golden Hours, but I walked around the mall and I was like, no, like I have to get Pink Sensibilities too. And I think I understand why people really like MAC now. It's that limited edition thing where you're like, no, if I don't buy this now, I won't ever get this again. And that's kind of what drove me to buy both of these, because I was just gonna buy this one, and then we walked around for a while, and then I was like, no, I have to go back, I have to buy the other one. So I did, so I got these two. I like them. They're pretty glittery though, so if you don't like glitter, I wouldn't recommend them, but so far, I think they're pretty cool. And then I just have one more quick little thing I think to show. Yes, okay. So I also ordered a bunch of stuff from CD Japan, which is a website where you can buy like Japanese magazines and stuff from. I placed an order for a bunch of magazines, and I also placed an order there for my husband's Valentine's Day present. It finally came. You know, I used style shipping, so you never know those things are gonna come. It took about a week and a half, so that was good. I won't show you what I got my husband, but I'll show you what I got. I picked up an Egg magazine. I got a Kera, and I got two Gothic Lolita Bibles. I got 49, right? Yeah, 49. And then I got the special 50th issue, which is like a collab with Innocent World. And it came with this really cute little diary. Yay! And that is my haul. I think that is everything. That went faster than I thought it would. So yeah, overall, really excited about all these products. I'm excited to finally be able to put them away because they've been sitting out for so long. But yeah, so as I kind of go through them, I'll probably let you guys know. I'm definitely going to do a review of the Volume 1 skincare set, kind of how I did with the Volume 2. I might end up, you know, posting some swatches on my blog or something. But otherwise, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and that you have a great day and that it wasn't too scattered. And yeah, so thank you guys for watching.